Welcome back to the show. We're Boyzone, or as Stephen called us, Michaela, Kitty, Shanice, and Rosaline. We're here to celebrate the life of our dear friend Steo, or as we used to call him, Stephanie. His life was far too short, but packed full of joy and laughter, often at my expense. Since we were teenagers, we had the pleasure and privilege of performing alongside Steo. He was my wingman on stage and in the studio, but there was so much more to Steo than the man standing in the spotlight.
Stephen came to me one day and he said, "Michelle, I've something I've got to tell you." I think he was about 15. And I said, "Okay." So I took him along and we went for a drink. And he said, "I'm gay, Michelle." And I said, "Stephen, I know." And he was just, he was delighted.
The last thing I ever thought is he was gay.
Stephen was tortured until he came out.
Nobody really cared, but it was a problem to him. Eventually, the Sun were going to do a story about it.
At the time, no boy bander in the world had ever come out. It was unprecedented territory.
It's hard for anybody to come out. All the odds are stacked against you there, and I thought he handled it very well.
It must have taken a lot of courage because, you know, he didn't know how the fans were going to react, and of course they reacted brilliantly.
He stayed with myself and my husband for 3 weeks, didn't watch the news, didn't read the papers. There was a war going on at the time, and the headlines were about Stephen.
He made a lot of guys feel good about themselves. If he can do that, I can.
It's easy to say it's an easy thing to do. Of course it's not. But he did it. Did it help others? Of course it did. Were those moves all part of a more inclusive, tolerant society? Of course it was. Did Stephen Gately add to that in 1999? Yes, he did.
I suppose when Stephen and Andy got together, you know, they knew they were going to get married at some point, you know. They were just right. They were just right for each other, you know. They loved each other.
We were so in love from day one, and after only 6 months, we'd been spending 3 months saying, "Marry me," to each other. And we ran away to Vegas, and we went to one of their little chapels of love. We had a somewhat spur-of-the-moment wedding. The next morning, we got a call from Stephen's agent telling us that it was all over the papers.
I think Andrew was the final piece of the jigsaw in Stephen's life. Now he had somebody he loved, he wanted to spend his life with. He was happy.
He had this wonderful, loving heart, and life hadn't always been easy on him, so he'd been a bit bruised.
Stephen was very conscious of where he came from and was prepared whenever the opportunity arose to give time, to give effort, to help things, to help young people, and he did so.
When I had just moved, you know, to London, to a big city, and he recognised that, and he was there to make me know it's going to be okay. You know, I'm here, it's going to be okay.
He was just amazing, you know, he was brilliant. He looked after everybody. He was always nice to everybody. He was a lovely, lovely, lovely person.
Steo grew up in the heart of working class Dublin, and he became an inspiration to people all over the world, not least our next guests. They're Irish lads and they're good friends of ours who've taken the world by storm, not to mention the record books. We've got a real treat for you now. For the first time ever on one stage, forming the biggest boy band in history. We were going to call it West Zone. Then we thought maybe Boys Life. But then we thought, let's just get on with it. Joining us on No Matter What, it's Nicky, Kian, Mark and Shane, better known as Westlife.
No matter what they do, then we would hear God say, and I will keep you safe from storm and sheltered from the storm.
Song.